I was questioning about making a sweater for a chicken. So I found a hand-knit pattern, and it did show the measurements. From one side to the other, on hand-knit, you're going to knit it from bottom to neck, but continue to the other bottom. But anyways, supposed to be 17 and a half inches long, so divided in half is 8 and a half, which I did get with this. Then the width of this is supposed to be 7 inches. Of course, it all depends on your chicken too. Well, I have 9 and a half inches, but the stockinette is 7 inches. The good thing with this sweater is you have to make tabs, whether you add them on to the knitted garment or if you sew on some Velcro at the bottom, so that when you wrap it around the chicken, it's going to overlap. Now, this would, I think, would be the front or the chest of the chicken. So now I'm going to make the back pretty much the same, except for minus these little tabs. So I did start out with garter stitch using my garter bar. For those of you that do not have a garter bar and you want to work garter stitch, I did 6 rows in the beginning there. So you would have to knit a row, take it off on waste yarn, get the carriage back to the other side, turn the fabric around, hang the last knitted row on, take the waste yarn off. Could be a little monotonous for some of you. You could reform every second row, but with 36 stitches, and actually I had 48 for the other piece, that could be a lot more work. So you may want to just do rib. I did start out with a latch tulle cast on because the E-wrap cast on was a little bit too tight. And then I'm going to bring the stitches from the machine onto the garter bar. And as you see, I will use my needle pusher. I bring the garter bar back to open up those latches. I remove the work. I take the yarn out of the carriage. Now I have my Russell lever here out, so it's not going to knit those needles. And I actually put my row counter off. I will put it back on for the next row. So when I turn it around, I've lined this up so that I am, actually the indents were facing up. So now the hooks go in that indent. You bring it, once you feel the yarn grabbed, you bring the garter bar down and off. And then you could either push the stitches back. For the machines that do not knit from this position, you're going to have to push the needles back. I'm going to put my row tripper back on again just so that it counts the rows. I knit across. And I do that 4 more times, so I have the 6 stitches. Now, on the other piece, after 3 rows, I made an eyelet because I'm going to put buttons on the other, on this piece here. And this is where, if this is actually too big, the buttons can be moved in so it overlaps a little bit more on the bottom here. So that's why it doesn't really matter too much. And the same if you're using Velcro. I like the waist yarn on here because it gives me something to grab instead of just having the main yarn on the needles and trying to grab it that way. So again, the indents are up. Because the carriage is over here and I have to move it over there and I have to turn this around, I put the end needle right on the end of the garter bar. And that way there, this little part here is not going to interfere. And again, I just bring the garter bar back. with the Chris Crafter guider bar, you can go like this. Of course, with this one, you can't because the hole's very little. The Chris Crafter, that hole goes the whole way. So when you turn it around, and it looks like a needle popped off here, but the stitch actually went on the prong, so I lucked out. But when you turn it around, you could see that hook and grab it. With this one here, you cannot do that. You just feel with it. Again, taking the yarn out, but I want to put my row counter tripper off. Turn it around. So I'm going to do that for four more rows. The other thing I can do is just push the needles back into work position from here. But I'm going to continue that for four rows. If you're working on the other piece that has the tabs, what I did next was I bound off six stitches at the beginning of the next two rows. So I did the six here, knitted across, bound off the six here, knitted across, and now I'm just going to reform the edges, but I also have to decrease. Now, I never reform the end needles. And doing this every other row, oh, wait a minute, I don't do it now. my pattern, I came up with knit four rows and decrease a stitch on both ends. So I need to knit two rows. I reset my counter back to zero so I can keep an eye on this. So I'm going to knit two rows. Now I'm going to reform these stitches. And you could do this a couple of ways. You could do this every second row like I'm doing here. Or if you have a seed stitcher, which is a double hook, like a double-eyed needle, but it has hooks on both ends. So I could actually, well, let me show you over here on the next one. I should not have knitted those or reformed those. I did find it easier myself, probably because I don't use that seed stitcher too often, just to reform every second row. But then I have to remember every four rows to decrease. Okay, so knit two rows. And actually, I'm going to decrease after this one, so let me do this first. And I'm going to decrease in here. I'm not going to do any decreases on the ends where I'm working the garter stitch. And this garter stitch is going to stop the piece from curling. Now, if you did rib on the bottom, well, you could still do garter stitch on the sides here. Or maybe you could do like a fisherman rib on the side. So you would knit a whole bunch of rows and then you can go down. I do have a video out there I showed doing the fisherman rib on the end stitches. Okay, so now I want to decrease. So I have these three stitches I reformed. I got the end stitch I need to do, but I want to take one more. So I just take my 3 2-prong transfer tool, move them one in, So I got my decrease right there. Different machines, different yarns are going to come up with a different pattern for this. So, okay, so knit two rows. Well, let me knit four rows. And I'll start over here. So I take the first needle back, I find the last knit stitch, I go one up, and then I unravel, try to, the rows above that. So like normal, reform, but then I push that behind and I use the other hook for the second one, and then the third one is like a normal reform. Let me zoom in on this so you could see how this tool works. Now I could actually go more than four rows by using the seed stitcher, but because I'm decreasing every four rows, I just want to do it this way. But just to show you how easy this tool is, so there's the two knit stitches together, so I go right above it, go down, reform to knit, push it back, make sure that latch is open on the other hook, pull it through, come back again, and do the last one. And of course, if I'm doing more than four rows, you just keep going back and forth. So here's those two knit stitches. So I go in this stitch right here. I do a knit, a purl, and a knit. So this neckline isn't really that deep. I waited till I got down to 12 stitches. So I'm going to try this one a little bit deeper. I have, let's see, 10, 14, 28 stitches now. And what I have to do is do this in half like you would a regular sweater. So I'm going to take the needles left of zero, put them out to hold. I have my carriage set to hold so it will not knit these stitches. But now I need to decrease on the neckline. And most necklines, from what I've seen, is every row. Really weird, but that's how it goes. So it's up to you if you want to do this every row, every other row. But I still need to reform these three stitches and decrease on the edge. And I think, yeah, I need to decrease on this edge too, because I'm doing that every four rows. So let's see, 3, 4, 5. It's only going to give me two more decreases over there. Well, let me see what happens. So I cannot decrease on the right side here anymore. And I'm going to reform And all I have to do is really this one here. I did work down to 3 stitches on the other part. So I need to work down to 3 stitches on this one as well. But now I'm just going to do it here at the neckline. So decrease here, one, two, I would do the other decrease, and there's my 3 stitches. Then what I did was I went across just to do that decrease, took the yarn out of the carriage, and then hand knitted these off. Okay, so that neckline does look like it's going to work out a little bit better than the other one. But sometimes these necklines are, one's deeper than the other. So I'm just going to bind off. These 3 stitches. And seem to have misplaced my scissors. Well, I have another pair in here. I'm going to cut that, pull that yarn through. Actually, I could let go of my cast-on comb. And then I am going to work on these stitches, reversing it. So from here, I am going to start the decrease. I need to take my carriage off a hold, grab my yarn. Decrease again. Decrease again. Reform the 3 stitches. And again, just keep decreasing on the neck edge here. Although I do need to do, I think I missed the one over here. No, that would be now. So I'm going to, after I reform these 3 stitches, do the decrease on the outside edge. And actually, that does look a little bit better. Just looking at this side here, I think this will fit a chicken. Of course, I have to find one to see if it will fit the chicken. And when I'm done with this and bound off this one, I will, no, I did miss it on the last one. So I'm not going to decrease on this. That's what I get for not paying attention. So I'll just keep going and I'll have one less decrease on the outside edge here. But that'll give me that neckline a little bit better is all. Okay, so once I'm done, bound off with this, I will sew the 2 pieces together. Then I will put buttons on the bottom of this piece here so that this fits right on it. And hopefully, I can find a chicken to try this on and get a picture of it. So it's all done here. And what you're going to do is, of course, you're going to put it over the hen's head. And then you're going to take the back part and put it underneath the wing, or pull the wing up so that you could button it. Now, I probably should have another button in here just in case. This way here it would be adjustable and it would fit 2 or 3 different hens. If I cannot find a hen to put this on, and get a picture of it. This is all I have right now. Pretty neat.